Welcome to my channel. If you like my videos, then kindly subscribe, like and watch. Thank you.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Welcome back. Problem 7.5. The statement of problem is that for given state of stress, determine the principal plane and principal stresses. So this is element that are the given state of stress. So we will have a given data. Let me write. So in given data, you can see that this is compressive stress, that is sigma x, and that is in compression. So it will be minus 60 megapascal. Clear? Again, this is sigma y, this is also in compression, so sigma y is again minus 40 megapascal. Clear? And this is the shear stress, 35 megapascal. So now you can see that this face is perpendicular to this axis, that is in positive direction, and again this force shear stress is also in positive direction. So tau of xy is positive, that is 60 megapascal. So what we have to find is, we have to find the first one is principal plane, which is known as theta p. Clear? So you have to find theta p, and the second part is that you have to find the principal stresses, that is sigma max and sigma minimum. Clear? So this is very easy problem. So let's start the solution. We will solve this problem by using transformation equation, and later on, after solving some problems using transformation equation, we will then solve this problem by using Mohr circle as well. So let's start with our part first. So that is to find theta p, principal plane. As you know that formula for principal plane is tangent of 2 theta p is equal to 2 tau of xy divided by sigma x minus sigma y. And you know this formula, I have also derived it in theory lecture, so we will just put the value. So 2 into tau of xy is 60. Clear? Sorry, not 60. Here it is 35 megapascal. So also correct it, this is 35 megapascal. So 35 megapascal. So I will also correct over here. So 2 into 35 divided by sigma x is minus 60. Clear? Minus 60 minus sigma y is minus 40. Clear? So that will be equal to 70 divided by minus 60 plus 40. Again, tangent of 2 theta p will be equal to 70 over minus 20, which will give you minus 3.50. Again, 2 theta p will be equal to tan inverse minus 3.50, and when you take the tan inverse of minus 3.50, so 2 theta p will be equal to minus 74.05. Minus means in clockwise direction. Clear? So theta p will be equal to minus 74.05 divided by 2, which is equal to minus 37 degree. Or if you add theta, this will be theta p1, so theta p2 will be equal to minus 37 plus 90 degree, so it will be equal to 53 degree. So these are the principal planes over which we will get the maximum and minimum stresses are the principal stresses. So let's move to part 2 of this, that is to find sigma max and sigma minimum, that is principal stresses. So by using transformation equation, we know that sigma max comma, let me choose a smaller thickness, sigma max comma sigma minimum is equal to sigma x plus sigma y divided by 2 plus minus, if you remember this formula, so this is sigma x minus sigma y divided by 2 whole square plus tau of xy whole square. Clear? So you have to just put the value for sigma max comma minimum will be equal to sigma x is minus 60, sigma y is minus 40 divided by 2 plus minus under the root minus 60 minus 40 divided by 2 whole square plus tau of xy is 35. So 35 whole square. This will be in under the root. Clear? So this will be equal to minus 100 divided by 2, that will be minus 50. Clear? Plus minus, this will be minus 50 square, because minus 100 divided by 2 minus 50 whole square plus 35 square, and when you take the under root, this will be equal to plus minus 36.4. so the value, this value, this whole value inside the under root there, this, when you take the under root of this value, so it will be 36.4. so this is sigma max comma minimum. Now sigma max or maximum stress is equal to minus 50 plus 36.4, clear, and sigma minimum will be equal to minus 50 minus 36.4. clear? So when you calculate this, this is minus 13.60 mega pascal, that is sigma max, and sigma minimum will be equal to minus 86.4 mega pascal. So these are the principal stresses, clear, and that will act at angle of minus 37 degree or 57.3 degree. So your initial state of stress was like this. Clear? So I will draw it over here, so you can see this is your initial, that is minus 60. Clear? This is in compression. This was also in compression, that is minus 40. Clear? And this top xy is in upward direction, 35 megapascal. So that is top xy 35 megapascal. You can also represent them as well. So let this is your initial axis, clear, this your x axis and this is your y axis. Clear? Now it is given that, let me extend this as well, or you can draw over here, this was your y axis and this is your x axis. Now you have to show the transform. So principal planes are minus 37, so this is your reference line, so you have to take 37 degree over here, so this will be your x dash. Similarly, this is 37 degree in clockwise, minus means clockwise direction, and again this is perpendicular y dash. Again this will be also 37 degree. So this is your new axis and your object will be, or element will be like that. So you have to represent sigma max, that will be here in this direction, that is in compression, clear? So that is minus 13.60, that is sigma x, sigma max there, and sigma y will be also in compression. Let me choose another marker. So sigma y will be also in this direction, compression, and this is sigma minimum, and that will be minus 86.4 degree, and this is your sigma maximum, that is minus 13.6 degree, and this is the angle which is 37 degree in clockwise direction, that is theta p1. Again if you are interested in theta p2, clear? So theta p2 will be equal to 37 plus 19 degree, clear? So we have find out the principal planes theta p1, theta p2, and we have also calculated sigma max, and this is the transformed stresses, or the principal stresses under the over the principal plane. I hope you have learned this problem. Thank you for watching.